Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I want to talk about undefined behavior and infinite loops. This is an interesting one, and things have changed in later versions of the standard. I thought you'd be interested in this. Now, of course, my name is Jason Turner, and I am available for code reviews and on-site training. On-site training is a great tool for team building. Let's look at this very simple example. I have int main while true. Now you'll note that main has no body to it. If I return 42 from main, I am going to see nothing here. Now if I create some new function called uncalled and I include CStudio so that I can actually call this function, I'm going to see something rather strange happen. I am going to go ahead and execute this code, and we will see in the output that hello world is printed. And as you can see, I never called hello world. In fact, main just had a while true and a return 42. And if I return 10 down here, say, from this, let's make it return an int so that we don't have multiple layers of undefined behavior. I am going to see that the program returned 10 and it printed hello world. This should be confusing and surprising to you. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains, and I wanted to let you know that I do personally use CLion in my work. I find the refactoring tools to be particularly valuable. The safe delete feature has saved me a ton of time when I've been doing refactoring on large projects. And great news, everyone! As of May 7th of this year, JetBrains has decided to make CLion free for non-commercial use. Be sure to check out the video description for more details on that. It is because infinite loops are undefined behavior before C++ 26. As of C++ 26, infinite loops are no longer undefined behavior. This is something that Clang aggressively optimized around, and you'll notice that there's no warnings being generated from the compiler here. GCC tended to be not so aggressive about this, so let's go back to an earlier version of GCC and see what it does, leaving us to wonder if GCC is ever going to actually finish the compilation. Now, I do have execute code turned on. Let's go ahead and turn off execute code. We can see that GCC did in fact give us this infinite loop, and the uncalled function is not called. Now, if we go to a newer version of Clang, and we will observe that I am in C++ 20 mode, but Clang still did leave in this infinite loop. I'm going to go back to this earlier version of Clang again so that we can discuss what exactly is happening. In this earlier version of Clang, we can see that the compiler sees undefined behavior in main, and therefore it basically removes the body of main. Now, when the binary is actually compiled, this uncalled function happens to coincidentally be laid out after main in the binary. So we have this label for main, and when our runtime starts our program, it jumps to the label called main. When it gets to the label called main, there's nothing there, and it just naturally falls through to the next label because there's no opcodes there, which is the uncalled label, which calls, puts, and prints hello world. Obviously, this is not the behavior that we wanted from this code. So, like I already said, the most recent versions of Clang actually do leave that infinite loop in there because it is required as of C++ 26 that infinite loops are not undefined behavior. Therefore, the compiler cannot correctly remove that loop anymore. Anyhow, that's a weird one. You've probably been bitten by something like this at some point, so feel free to leave a comment about your experiences. And otherwise, thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe.